right, here we go. First Habitat weekend of the year. I got Buck Slayer with me.
Hi.
We're gonna put her on the Habitat hook. I'm gonna run the saw. We're gonna see you back when we get back to the cabin. See a nest up there. Okay, now push that orange lever forward all the way. Good job. Thank you.
we do this one first.
This is the section I'm having Matt come in to mulch.
This side too?
We're taking the food plot all the way into there.
I didn't realize that.
This way.
Oh.
on the north side of Parker's food plot, and it's a known doe bedding area right in here. We're standing maybe about 70 yards from her, maybe 50 yards from her food plot. And this is where the bucks come in. If you can see, it's got like a hill to it, and in those pines and stuff is where the doe's bedding. The bedding area is right there. So what we want to do is we want to give them more side cover. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of start hinging all in here to give them more of like a bedroom, but we're still going to leave the inside open, and we're not going to do little hinges in there, but the bigger stuff on the outside here to give them side cover. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll do the big stuff first. We'll start with this one. That should drop on its own. So just grab the hook and come over here, get out of the way.
Going this way.
still creaking. In that last section, you could tell that I had trouble with these maples, right? Soft maples. It's because anybody who's hinging and you got mature woods, the maples will just grow straight up like a pole. And it's really hard to get them to hinge into stay attached unless you have something for them to fall on. So now, after all that, I have the hard maple there, and I'll be able to lay everything on top of that. So, but this will be my nucleus right here to get everything, this little hard maple stump right here. I'm gonna try to get everything to create this outside edge here. And as you can, I don't know if you can see inside there, we'll take you for a tour, but that's the bedding up inside there. Okay, ready? We got more to do. That one, we'll stay away from that one. That one's still creaking. We're gonna go this way. We're gonna take these soft maples here and come this way with them.
Got your hat. Don't lose it. Where are we going?
We're gonna go right over here. Here, take this. I'm gonna grab the habitat hook. Just go right over there.
Oh.
don't always work perfect, but sometimes it does. Low bat. All right, we're over at Parker's plot, working on her bedding area that's north of her plot. And what we're whenever you sat in her spot, you does come out of here, and I'm gonna show you why. We're gonna walk in now, but this run. Buck rub. This is where the bucks would come into this bedding area, checking for does, and then we would watch them come out. All of them were, I think the biggest one was a four pointer that we saw. But I want to show you what's going on and why it's. Well, of course it's by food, so that's why it's a bedding area. But what's going on is. I'll get you on the other side of it, is that there's elevation to it. And I'll show you. This is the area that we just came in and hinge cut. But as you can see, let's see if I can back up enough. As you can see, it drops off, and then it comes up, and then it drops off again, and then this is where all the doe beds are in here. You got a mixture of evergreens and all kinds of doe beds in here. You could just see them all closer to the food plot right there. So what we did was is we wanted to give them more security. Is here, I'll sit in one of the beds, right here, one of the beds, and you can see we hinged all of this to give them side cover. That's the new keyword everyone talks about, is side cover, and I agree with it. It's not like I'm doing it because it's a new thing to do. It's I agree with it. It works. And so these hinge cuts in here were not for bedding. That's why it's kind of like, I guess you could call it, it's for screening, side cover. Some of them held, some of them didn't. Then all I did was come back in here, me and Parker, and we opened up the runs. Like here, this was the run right here. But I don't trust that that's gonna fall. But this one's not. Because it's on top of the stump right there, which will put out sprouts right there. I might come in and actually cut that lower, a couple of those to put it lower for deer sprouts. But as you can see, we open this up. And now there's a run coming through here. I didn't expect these to hinge, so, you know. They don't hinge, but if you can get them to stay, they give you side cover. So that's what I did. It's a worthless tree, if you ask me. Oh, that one creaking back there. And then here you go. This is the mess we made. Beech trees. Favorite tree to hinge cut. And that one, I'm guaranteeing that one's going to make it and give lots of side cover. And now when you're here and you're looking into where the does are bedding, this is going to be a big giant mess, and they're going to have more cover to go in there. So you might get more family groups that'll be able to hold in there, you know, divide in between there. So anyway, it was a tank of gas, and I think it's going to do good.